Good morning, one and all. Today we'll discuss about welding. Welding is a metal joining process where we melt the metal in order to join both the metals. Now, if we are using a consumable electrode, then we melt the electrode and we join both the metals with the help of metal which we got from the electrode. If it is a non-consumable electrode, then we heat the base metals and at the junction, means where the metal is getting melted, with the help of some pressure, we join both the plates. So we have two types of electrodes, consumable electrode and non-consumable electrode. So welding is a metal joining process where we join both the metals either by using a consumable electrode or non-consumable electrode, and these two metals can be similar metals or dissimilar metals. So we have two different types of joints, like temporary joint and permanent joint. Temporary joint is where you can remove the joint without destroying the component. Example is our nut and bolt system. If we once joined using nut and bolt, and if we want to remove it, disassemble it again, then we can unscrew it and we can disassemble the component. But in case of permanent joint, we have to break the workpiece in order to separate the parts. So welding is a permanent joining process where if you want to remove the joint, you have to break any of the pieces which you are joining. So here is the definition of welding: joining of two or more metals or plastic of similar or dissimilar metals by using filler material or by heating of two parts is called welding. This welding is classified into many types. First one is gas welding. So depending upon the fuel we are using, this gas welding is of three types: oxyacetylene, air acetylene and oxyhydrogen. So in one cylinder if you have oxygen, in another cylinder you have acetylene, like this. So depending upon the combination, gas welding is divided into three types. And next one is spot welding. In spot welding, you have butt welding, resistance welding, you have butt welding, spot welding, seam welding and projection welding. We are going to learn about all these weldings in coming up slides. Next one is arc welding. In arc welding, you have carbon arc, metal arc, plasma arc, gas arc welding. We also call it as MIG welding, metal inert gas welding. Next, gas tungsten arc welding, we also call it a tungsten inert gas welding. And this electro beam welding and laser beam welding are unconventional machining processes, and that's why he named it as newer welding process. In case of electron beam welding, we use a race of electrons to join that particular area. The heat liberated because of the ionization of gases will create some heat at the junction, and we join both the plates. And in case of laser welding, the heat produced because of the layer will melt the metals, and we join both the metals with the help of that melted metal. We can use the filler material if the thickness of plates is more. If thickness of plates is less, we can eliminate the usage of filler material. Next one is solid state welding, like friction welding, ultrasonic welding, explosive welding and diffusion welding. So we discuss few of this weldings in coming up slides. So we have different types of welding. First one is butt welding. Butt welding is if you join both the plates side by side, then we call it as butt welding. Similarly, if the welding is getting overlapped, see these two are lap joints. If two plates are overlapping each other and if you are performing welding, then it is called as lap welding. See, if both are getting welded in this area, we call it as transfer fillet welding, and this is longitudinal fillet weld. So however, as both the components are getting overlapped to each other, we call it as lap welding. This is edge joint where two metals will get welded at their edges, and this is a T joint where we keep both the plates at 90 degrees to each other and we weld. And this is a corner joint where the corners of the plates will get welded. So these are the different types of weld. Similarly, we have different welding positions. If we are placing the weld over the bench, means on a flat surface, then we call it as flat position. if two wells are held horizontally like this, two plates are held horizontally like this, and if we are welding, then we call it as horizontal welding position. And if two plates are held vertically like this, then this is vertical welding position. And if the welding is overhead, it means above our head level, then we call it as overhead welding positions. Compared to these three welding positions, overhead welding position is very difficult to make. Similarly, flat position is very easy to make. This is edge preparation. Edge preparation is to increase the strength of weld joint. So depending upon the thickness of the material, we go for the edge preparation. If thickness of the material is less, then the edge preparation can be small like this. It can be V or it can be square like this. So you can make small edge preparations in order to go for welding of small metals. But if thickness of material is increased, then we have to go for higher edge preparation methods like double V and W, so that the deposition of weld at these areas will increase. As a result, the strength of the weld will also increase. This is tack. Tack is the temporary joint which we make in order to hold both the metals before performing the welding operation. As we have seen the classification, let us first look at gas welding. Gas welding is of different types like oxyacetylene, aerosilane, oxyhydrogen. However, the cylinders and the working temperature will vary. The principle of working is same for all the joints. Here you have two cylinders. These are the pressure regulating valves. These are the controlling valves. It means the volume of oxygen and volume of acetylene. These are pressure regulators to check what pressure of gas you have inside. So here you have torch. So now this flame which you are getting in gas welding is of three types: oxidizing flame, reducing flame, and neutral flame. In case of oxidizing flame, we'll have more of oxygen and less of fuel. And in case of carburizing flame, you have more of fuel and less of oxygen. And in case of neutral flame, we have equal quantities of both oxygen and fuel. Now, if the percentage of fuel is increasing more than oxygen, then the temperature released will be high, and that type of gases will create flame of higher length and higher temperature. As a result, the metal which is melting is also more, and mostly this type of carburizing flames will be used for cutting the metals. So here in case of gas welding, so depending upon the workpiece which you are using, material of the workpiece, we control the flame. So here you have the control valves. This is more portable. It means you can move to the place you want. You have lengthy wires and you can take to the place you want. So that is the advantage with this system. So now depending upon the different types of gases which we are using, we get different temperatures. See, oxyacetylene is 3200, oxyhydrogen is 2800, oxybutane is 2700. Like this, depending upon the temperatures which depending upon the fuel which we are using, the temperature will also vary. Next, this the combination of oxygen and acetylene will produce 3200 degrees centigrade. And next, this type of gas welding is used for joining of metal plates if it is thin, and it is used for joining both ferrous and non-ferrous materials. And mostly this type of gas welding operation is used in the automobile and aircraft industries. These are used mostly for sheet fabrication methods. And the advantage with this type of gas welding is you need not to go for high-skilled operator. The cost of the equipment is less when compared to TIG welding and MIG welding. TIG welding is tungsten inert gas welding, and MIG welding is metal inert gas welding. It can be used at any site. You can carry your cylinders to the required place and you can perform the welding operation there. As I told, it is more portable. It means you can conveniently move the equipment here and there. And this type of gas welding, if you increase the flame, it means if you go for carburizing flame, means more of fuel and less of oxygen, in such cases we can use this welding for cutting operation also. But this gas welding is also having some limitations, like the surface finish of the weld is very less, and after performing the welding operation you need to go for finishing operation. As high amount of heat is getting generated, the areas will get affected by the heat and the properties of base metal will also change, and there are high risks of safety issues. This is only suitable for thin metals. You cannot go for welding of large size metals, and the rate of metal joining is also less. So this is the picture of gas cutting. So as I told you, here we use carburizing flame for cutting the glass, but the thing is, the metals which we are using should be very thin, and at the same time it should get oxidized fastly. It means the heat affecting the other areas, the materials which is present at this area should get evaporated so that the metal will get cut fastly. So this is a reaction that generally takes place when we cut the steel. And 27,000 calories of heat will be liberated during this process. Next one is arc welding. In case of arc welding, we have two terminals, like positive and negative. So here we have the concept of direct polarity and indirect polarity. Okay, now in case of direct polarity, the positive of the positive of the terminal will be connected to the workpiece. In case of negative polarity, it means the reverse polarity, the positive of the workpiece will be connected to electrode. So here the connection means the straight polarity or reverse polarity will depend upon whether you are going to choose for a consumable electrode or non-consumable electrode. See, for example, if you are using a consumable electrode, then give positive to the electrode. If you are using a non-consumable electrode, then give negative to the electrode. So wherever we are connecting positive, that metal will melt faster. It means if positive is to the workpiece, it means the electrode should not melt. It means it is a non-consumable electrode and metal, the base metal, should melt. And if you are giving positive to the electrode, it is a consumable electrode and the electrode should melt and not the workpiece. So like this, depending upon the type of welding process you are making, you select the polarity, whether you need a straight polarity or reverse polarity. Here in case of arc welding, you can use both AC and DC currents. So this, that is about arc welding. Principle of arc welding. Arc welding is a welding process in which heat is generated by an electric arc struck between an electrode and the workpiece. Electric arc is luminous electrical discharge between two electrodes through ionized gas. Here there will be no joint between the electrode and the workpiece. Because of the gas which is presenting here in between both the electrodes, a spark will generate, and thus that spark will help for melting the metal or melting the electrode. So because of the ionization of gases between both the electrodes, arc welding is done. So you can use AC current supply and also DC current supply for arc welding. So here you can use a consumable or non-consumable electrode. If it is every electrode will have a coating that is called as flux coating. Flux is used for protecting the weld from getting oxidized with the environmental gases. It means if you are joining both the metals, and if you are with the help of some consumable electrode, the melted metal will be used for joining both the metals, and the flux will form a layer of slag over this joint. And now once the metal gets cooled on, we hammer and we remove this excess material. So the purpose of the slag is to protect the weld from getting oxidized with the air. Next, in arc welding, transformers are used, and in DC generators, in AC welding, transformers are used, and in DC generators or rectifiers are used. Silicon controlled rectifier is used to convert AC to DC. Arc welding is more expensive than DC welding. AC welding is more expensive than DC welding. Straight polarity, as I told you, if workpiece is connected to
positive, then we call it as straight polarity. And if workpiece is connected to negative, then we call it as reverse polarity. So this arc welding is classified into different types, like carbon arc welding, plasma arc welding, metal arc welding, TIG welding, MIG welding, and atomic hydrogen welding. Now let us first look at carbon arc welding. Here the electrode is made with carbon or graphite. This carbon electrodes are soft and more consumable. So here, this is the workpiece, this is a filler rod, and these are the carbon electrodes. Because of the arc produced between these two electrodes, the filler material which we are using will melt, and this will join both the metals. If you want to go for if you have thinner materials, like sheet of smaller thickness, then we need not to go for filler rod. You can directly use both the carbon electrode, produce the arc, and because of ionization of the gas, both the metals will join. The advantage with this carbon arc welding is there is no noise during the welding. Electrode is non-consumable. It means here either we melt the workpiece. If workpiece is not sufficient, then we go for using some filler rod, but the electrode will not get melted. This equipment is portable. It means you can carry it to the place we want, and the cost of the equipment is less. Flat welding can be made easily. As I told, flat welding is the easiest type of welding which we can make using any type of welding technique. But the limitation with arc hole is more blow holes because of turbulence in DC current. What happens is when there is a turbulence in the material, it means if the flow of material is too high, then the air will get trapped into the metal and form some blow holes. And that blow holes will create the defect in the welding. And because of that defect, the strength of the weld will decrease. And next, it is not suitable for overhead and vertical welds. It means as the flow of material is high, and if the material is not getting solidified at that required area very fastly, then you cannot use it for overhead welding and vertical welds. Next one is TIG welding. TIG welding is tungsten inert gas welding. Here, in case of TIG welding, you have a tungsten electrode which is non-consumable. Now, you have two base metals here. Now, what we generally do is we give positive to the base metal and negative to the tungsten electrode. This tungsten electrode will melt the base metal because of the heat produced, and these two metals will get joined. Now, in case the material which is getting melted here is not sufficient, then we use some extra rod, that is filler rod, in order to get melted, and means in order to fill the gap between both the base metals. And here tungsten inert gas, so here we use some inert gas which uses as shielding gas here. So inert gases will very rarely react with the atmospheric gases. At very very high temperature only the inert gas will react. If not, the reaction of inert gas is not possible. So we use this inert gas to protect the weld area from the gases present in the atmosphere. That is about TIG welding. In the coming up classes, we'll look at different types of weldings, few more types of weldings. Thank you for listening.